Hello and welcome back to another episode of Ratchet and Clank PS4 Edition. We should all be back on a normal track now. And we can actually get another weapon here. What are the Doom Blades? 270,000. I don't think I'm going to save up for that. I think I'm going to get the Pixelizer right now. You know what? I should get the Magna Blaster just because it's pretty inexpensive. And I need a long range weapon maxed out. So let's see.
I just bought one of those.
Let's go and upgrade
myself.
This.
I can
a little
vouch
more.
For its effectiveness.
Because we can.
Oh, nice!
Make sure we get all these. And what's this? Ammo. Ammo's always good. Spend the rest on ammo here. There we go, now we have a nice long range weapon to use. And it didn't break the bank either. Alright, so yeah, this is gonna be like 10 times easier than it was on our first playthrough. Now that we can use the helipack.
It's down here.
I think I did read something in the patch notes about possibly fixing that, where you can get stuck in some places like that. So I don't know if that was the case. And I can just imagine them thinking, you know, oh, this is gonna be great, we'll be able to save states, you know, so that way, you know, when people quit the game and come back, they're not restarted at the beginning of the level. Well, that's great and all, but that could also get people stuck. I'm pretty sure it was not intended to be that difficult, or for it to be done at all without the helipack. But that's fine, we made it work. But I imagine someone who hadn't played the game before, that would get them a little annoyed. Be like me in 2002 when I played the game for the first time. I had to call my friend over for help. Yeah, there's just no way out of here.
Sewer pumps activated.
I would stop the game right now to see if I could fix it.
Now.
But you see how much easier this is. In fact, we're actually gonna get stuck here.
Right here. The water is rising.
Yep, I can see that, but not in any level we can. Yep, see, it was plenty of time. Any secrets in here? Yep, there is a gold bolt in there that we need to get the, gas mask? Something that lets you breathe underwater. I don't know what it's called in this game. Swim down and get that. And that's the only other gold bolt on this thing.
This place looks like bad news.
Here's the rhino guy.
Clank.
Wait, did you just give me the rhino? Why did I do the little animation like I got the rhino? I don't have the rhino. I forgot to mention how much I hate this weapons thing. Yeah, I don't have all the roundup cards. I'm still missing two. So I don't know what that was about. Must have just been some kind of glitch. But we do have this now, right? Actually, don't recall. Are you sure you want to use the auto-hack program? You will not get any bolts awarded, and you will not be able to get the trophies related to trespass puzzles without starting a new game. Yeah, I guess. That's what we need to get bolts for. How many bolts do we get? Yeah, we got 1,000 bolts. It's probably worth it. I didn't do any the first time because I wanted to get that trophy for doing them all without auto-hack.
Hey, you got one!
Is that a duplicate? Yeah, it was a duplicate, okay. There are still two we need to get.
Travel to other planets and stuff. Holo cards are everywhere.
Yep, I'm sure we've missed a couple there on our first playthrough. And we should be able to get that through this one. Now here's the question though, are we still gonna have to pay a crap ton of money after we get all the cards?
What do you say, pal? Feel like entering the race?
Because in the first game, it was a lot of money. I think it was only like 150,000, but in the original game, that was like a ton of bolts. Yeah, you didn't get any bolt multipliers or anything. And just bolts in general were a little bit harder to find. And there goes my multiplier, just because it, for some reason, felt like shooting me forward to hit that instead of slamming the ground like I wanted it to. And actually, it's out of that pretty quick. The Amoeboids are pretty good for getting your gold multiplier up because they split into multiple enemies. That just makes sense. Oh wow, this thing shoots 5 bullets now, that's really cool. And we've leveled it up to level 7. That's 20% more damage. Doesn't do that much damage, though. I want to kill most of these guys myself to get my full multiplier up. Yeah, let's get the pyro cider out. Or the lava cider, or the whatever you call it. There's some rare titanium. Through here. Somehow through there. Not sure how to get that. Must be on the other side. There you go. Like over there.
Attention residents of Blackwater City. In lieu of a security team, we've released a whole mess of extermabots into the city. We also expect automated tanks to the law. The onboard AI doesn't let them distinguish between trespassers and locals, so probably best to stay indoors.
Artillery. Yeah, watch out for that tank. Level 9 already. And let's just do this. I don't know how much damage this is going to do. Hits him with a lot of bullets, so I feel like he should do quite a bit. Yeah, that can do too bad. We need a lot of bolts. We already have enough for another mega weapon. Here's where the rare titanium is. How would I get up there? Shot thing except for that one, but that's well, there's one way up there. Where does that lead to? The heck would you get up there? Maybe something to do with this button. Oh no, it just lowers it. Fair enough.
Nice!
And there, now we get our 3-2 rare opinion. Alright, moving on. Any other secrets we've passed? Apparently there's some rare titanium right by our ship that I passed. Oh, they hit me, that was unfair. I actually want to head down here and kill these guys so I can get the up. Behind me. Yeah, great way to get a remote flyer up is to go take out these guys. Where I would feel like the pirate side. There he goes, get some ammo. Hopefully for this. Yes.
All servos to point to containment center. Grenades, all servos to the containment center.
Please stop telling me what I have. Already almost at times 10 again.
Oh,
I got you. That was another tank. Oh, we got a lot of bolts in the process. We have a bunch of things to get that out. So, times 20 though, for that point. I'm sure that's happening.
Put the race back on.
It'd be kind of cool if we could, like, if they'd replace the gold bolts that you normally get with card packs. You know, on the second playthrough. I can put a card pack back here where the gold bolt was. It's not really important for going back there unless you want the bolts, but I'm pretty sure I could get some of those bolts like that. Yep, there are all the bolts. So no reason to bother hopping up there again. If I didn't have a higher multiplier for this room, that could have given me a lot of bolts. I got 3,000 times 4.
The city is now Amoeboid free, and we have two citizens to thank, Ratchet and Clank. The race is back on, so stay tuned for...
Hey, I'm Starlene.
Alright, I assume it's just going to be the same races.
Get ready, racers! On your mark! Get set!
Should be easy
go!
Enough.
We're told...
Okay, so for a trophy on this level, we need to defeat
or
complete the gold cup
if you want.
Under 1 minute and 35 seconds, which I think is actually pretty difficult.
You want to go for the world
how fast
record,
I can do the
you?
Other
I'm
two
ready when
here.
You are.
So let's give this a go.
Get ready, racers. On your mark. Get set.
Accelerate again.
Go. Fan favorites, Ratchet and Clank are back.
I'm not sure what I hit there. So we pretty much have to boost as often as possible and not hit anything like that. Any shortcuts would also help. You know, not taking... Oh, you know what? I'm hitting the trick by accident. So we need to get as many boosts as possible. Pretty much use them as quickly as possible too. This one has been a really bad run so far.
Sorry, Furball. This one's mine.
It's important we get all these rings that we can. Skip that a little bit. Why is it actually important that we win? Because, you know, like I said,
that boost pad really gave him a boost.
It does not matter how fast are you going in the beginning of the race to win, just minus how fast you're going at the end of the race.
Underdog Ratchet is now in second place. Can he catch
all
up
right.
in time?
That could just mess me up right there. Yeah, that was close. That was real close. We had a good second lap, but the first lap and the third lap weren't as good. So 143, I feel like we could shave a little bit of time off that as long as we do better in the beginning.
Better luck next time.
So let's try that again. I hate how long you have to wait.
Oh, sorry.
So you have to listen
to
her
speak. Give it another try.
And then go again.
Get ready, racers.
Alright, so hit more of the rings in this first lap here and don't accidentally hit any tricks.
Just a little background on some of our racers today. Rick Blastex is riding a modified Orion S12. Newcomer Victor Equinox is riding a Vortex 2000. And Chester St. Cloud is
that ring's not worth it because I'm going to skip that area right there. Skip that a little bit.
That looked like it hurt.
Oh, that was bad. That was bad. That. Okay, well, that seems a little bit unfair on the whole scheme of things. Spawning is right in front of the bombs, and then into more bombs. There was a similar skill point like this in the first game where you have to do this, and I remember doing the race dozens of times until I found the best route. But it was hard. I don't think this one's quite so hard considering how close we got on the first try. So yeah, we're way behind on this one, since we crashed so much.
Underdog Ratchet is now in second place. catch up in time?
So we may as well try and win.
Sorry, Furball. No, we're not. This one's mine.
This guy's too far. Ahead. Alright, so didn't do much better that time.
Sorry, Ratchet. Better luck next time.
I think we may have even done a little bit worse. Yeah, we pretty much have to do a perfect run.
Sorry, but come back anytime and give it another try.
Yes, I plan to right now.
Get ready, racers. On your mark. Get set. Go!
Don't hit any of these boxes.
Are back. Can they repeat the same magic we saw during our last competition? Let's
Probably.
Find out.
Oh, out of my way, dude.
Oh, I missed that boost. That's not good.
That's a costly
yeah,
error.
Yeah, that's not good. Like she said, that's a costly error. Because now I've got no boost.
What is this, your first time?
Alright, if we get a good second lap, we can make up for that.
This race is brought to you in part by Megacorp, makers of this year's most anticipated toy, the Proto Pet. Pre-order yours today.
Missed that boost again. No, I jumped too late.
Losing precious time.
See, now, here's the thing. There is no way right now to restart this race. I have to finish it.
That boost pad really gave him a boost.
Wait, actually, there might be a quit race. There's a quit race. Okay. See, but now I have to quit the race,
sorry,
go through the little
come
cutscene.
Back anytime and give it another try.
Originally, there was a restart race option. Yeah, there's no way we're gonna beat that. Alright, this is the last try I'll do on camera, and then after that, I'll try it off camera until I get it.
And they're off. Just a little background on some of our racers today. Rick Blastack is driving.
You know, everything's it's always easier off camera, because you don't have to worry about doing commentary or anything.
And Chester St. Cloud is riding a Romulus Turbo 4.
Yeah, I've already hit like 4 boxes.
What is this, your first time?
And Ratchet shows us a boost of speed.
Yeah, that was too short of a lap. Alright, I'm just gonna quit this one and I'll be back
sorry,
hopefully with that trophy.
Come back anytime and give it another Ratchet takes the lead.
There we go, and at 133, we come in second place. That should have gotten us the skill point.
Aw, sorry, but come back anytime and give it another try.
Yep, we did get that. That's a sign that you may want to recalibrate how your racing works, is if it's the fastest time you've ever gotten, you don't win. But yet, you
wanna race
again? I have to go do it again. And just not do anything for the first two laps and then speed ahead at the third lap in order to actually win the race. That's why I really hate the racing in like every Ratchet and Clank game. It just doesn't feel like what you do matters. Specifically because, you know, all the other guys in this race, they just go at a consistent speed, and then that speed just adjusted to how fast you were going. And like, you know, the boosts don't matter for them. They don't use boosts. They don't use tricks. They just follow along the path. Like, tell me to boost right now, but no need to. Because I'm still on lap two. I only really need to on lap three. Like, pretty much no matter how good you do throughout the entire race, you're always going to be towards the end. And then you have to speed up at the end. This is lap 2 to 3. But yeah, that took me quite a few tries in order to get that skill point. I realized that I needed to do tricks more often. Pretty much every time I was in the air, I needed to do tricks in order to get enough boosts. Alright, for this lap, I'll start speeding up a little bit. Great, speed up! And immediately hit some boxes and almost die. Alright, now I really need to pick it up and go past this guy, which I should be able to do right here. There we go. See, all you gotta do is speed up at the end. And despite getting a much worse time...
Holy wowzers, you're like amazing! You should think about going pro.
Holy wowzers. I don't think I needed to do that, since this is just duplicate Rhino Power. But hey, if it counts as a duplicate. Yeah, so I got 152 there instead of my 133, and I won this time and lost last time. That's not really how races should work. Alright, so that pretty much is going to do it for this episode. I think I've got everything I can here. We've got one more gold bolt in this planet that we cannot get until we get the respirator so we can breathe underneath the water. But other than that, I'm going to go ahead and end it here. Remember to leave a like if you enjoyed, and I will see you guys next time.